we got a slight mukbang going on. Okay. Let me come down. Let my cane go. Got my cane. Bro, they always be skimping on me. Look at this. Okay, look at this. Why do fries look like that? They don't look like that. Like, I should have fries. I should have bounty for my fries. And everybody know that fries on my face too. Four. So, they need to stop playing me. And they go, one catch up. Oh, they put hot sauce in there. But anyway, this is a movie. I've been doing the videos for a minute. This mukbang is about my skin peels, my chemical peels, because I made videos prior to this, just explaining like the process of the skin peels. But everybody be asking me like, what? Like, they think it's disgusting when your skin peeling, but it's actually like, you know, when you use an exfoliator, that's exactly what an exfoliator is doing. It's not peeling your skin, but it's taking away skin cells off your skin. That's what an exfoliator is. Now you know. But anyway, so I get chemical peels every 2 weeks. And I've been getting them since June. So that's been like 8-9 months on a day, I think. So I recently got one, and that's what the videos are gonna be from, that I'm gonna put in this video. But I wanted to show y'all, like, sometimes my skin peels, I guess it just depends on the weather, I'm not sure, but sometimes my skin peels a lot. Like, it'll peel like from here, and then it'll go up, and then everything just peeling. And then I got a few skin tone glider too. Like, my face always been darker than my neck, like my chest area, but now I'm like light bright, like crazy light, whatever. But so let me tell you what a chemical peel is, first of all, because you need to be educated on what you put on your face, first of all. And a lot of the stuff that you be buying in the stores, you really don't know what that is, if you want to be honest, because a lot of it is just soap, and it's clogging your pores, and it's making you break out more. And that's why people be having bad skin. That's why I don't let air in it. And everybody tell me what they be using on their skin. Because baby girl, baby boy, like, everything don't work on everybody. Like, I had to figure that out the hard and the most expensive way possible. Because I used to get everything. I've had Neutrogena, I've had Proactive, I've had Clean and Clear, store brand stuff, Nozema. I still use Nozema, but still, I use everything that everybody told me to use. Clear still. And that stuff didn't work for me. So I had to figure out what worked for me. I went to a dermatologist. Their chemical peels didn't work on me. Like, it worked for like a short amount of time, but it wasn't working the way that these chemical peels are working. Everyone's not that mama. But so I go to an esthetician now, pretty much. An esthetician is not a dermatologist, because they don't go through medical school, but they're a cosmetologist. So they get their cosmetology license, and then they work on people's skin. So my esthetician works in a plastic surgery office. So boom, a chemical peel is acid. It's It can be more than one acid. It can be one acid. So pretty much what she does, I should have gotten a video, but it just be too much with having to hold the camera. And then you can find some other videos where they have like the camera placed, but like for me, holding the camera the whole time is just stressful. And then I don't know if it's on my face or off my face or what. But so the chemical peel is, she washes my face with like a cleanser, and then after she washes my face, she puts like this face mask on that helps with acne and breakouts. So it's gonna tingle, like it tingles and it feels like weird. But after that, she tries to like make it stop tingling. So she wipes the mask off, and then after that, she puts the acid on there. So she puts acid all over my face, all under my chin area, cause I had acne under there too. And then she pops the pimples that I have, like white pimples or blackheads. She pops all of those on my face while the acid is on there. And then she puts another layer of acid. She puts like, I believe it's like 4 or 5 layers of acid on my skin. And just recently, she started doing 2 different acids. At first, she was doing 1. Now she's doing 2. And 2 has made me peel more than I've ever peeled. Like, I would have this skin, and you can't take it off. Like, you can't pull it off. You gotta let it sit there and fall off by itself. So you're sitting around with dead skin all over your mouth, all over your lip, and you can feel it. Just like, you go out there, remove your face, and you can feel it peeling. And it's just embarrassing sometimes. So I don't even go outside if I'm peeling. Like, I don't do like anything on the weekends, like, and it peels for a few days. Like, if I get my chemical peel Wednesday, it's gonna peel till Sunday. Actually, it's gonna peel beyond that. But after Sunday, if you get yours Wednesday, you could use your toner on your face and you can wipe it, kind of like make it go away. But until then, you gotta sit there and let it peel. And most times, if I'm going outside, I try to put like a stock on my face or something. But yeah. So, hold on. She put the acid on there. So she finished popping all the pimples and taking all the blackheads out. So she put more acid on my face. More acid. And then she put sunscreen on after it stopped tingling. So I have the fan on it so it'll dry, the acid will dry on my face. And then she put sunscreen on. So after you get the peel, you could, like, if you get it early in the morning, you could wash your face that night. But if you get it like in the evening, then don't wash your face. Wash it the next morning so that it can stay on there and it can work. But after you get your chemical peel, that the next day, it's gonna be real tight. Like, your face is gonna be like you know how your face feel when you got those face masks on? It's gonna feel real tight. And then, it's gonna start peeling on Friday. You're gonna start seeing white flakes on your skin. And that's pretty much what happens. So like, what the thing I like about chemical peels is the fact that it doesn't just clear acne that's on your skin. It takes away the dark marks. So like, as the skin is peeling, it's peeling away the dark marks too. And I've had acne since I was like 12 years old or 13 years old. So all the dark marks that I have on my skin is going away, and you can clearly see that it's very faint now, but it's still there. So the more if I continue getting the chemical peels, my dark marks will eventually be non-existent. All right. But I'm gonna show y'all. I'm gonna put pictures in this video of how my face used to be during the summertime. It was bad. Like, my skin had broke out bad. And then people have acne, they ask me like what I did to clear my skin. And I'm like, oh, well, it's chemical peels. Or then again, certain people don't understand that when my skin is peeling, that it's a chemical peel. It's not my face being dry. A lot of people be like, oh, your skin look a little dry. What's that on your face? And I'll be like, just wait until my skin clear all the way up. And I'm gonna be popping. Like, popping. Okay. But that's that information. This video. And if you have any questions, just let me know. Just DM me on my social medias or comment below. And I'll answer your questions about, you know, clearing up your skin if you're dealing with like really bad cystic acne. I have cystic acne. Also, a lot of chemical peels are not the only, like, you can't just get a chemical peel and expect your face to just clear. It's what you eat too. Like, if you eat a lot of greasy foods or dairy, that'll make you break out too. So getting a probiotic, usually I get the gummies. I don't like taking pills. So I get the gummy probiotics, and I take two gummies every morning, and it cleans out your system. But you still gotta change your diet. So like, I stopped eating dairy completely. I don't eat dairy at all. And my skin has been reacting well, and I could tell, like, when I eat like cake or something sweet, my skin will start to break out, and that's from the dairy. So you can't just get a chemical peel and be like, oh, my skin just gonna clear up because I got, no, you gotta start eating better, you gotta start taking a probiotic, and you gotta start, they say exercising and stuff makes it better, but I don't exercise, so. But yeah, that's just my point of view. Again, if you have any questions or comments, just leave them below. Hit me up on my social media. That's it.